I'm old man Steve, and when I'm not hunting bear in Sugar Grove or deer in Elburn, I'm at home watching TV 17 outdoors.
Good evening and welcome to High School Basketball TV 17. We're up here at Woodstock North High School. It's the sectional matchup between the Rockford Boylan Titans and the Kaneland Knights. Rockford Boylan, the record is 29-2. They're a very good team. Looks like they got a bit of a height advantage over the Knights. They got some pretty tall players up there that go 6'7", 6'8", 6'5". So the Knights will have their hands full with those forwards for the Rockford Titans, Rockford Boylan Titans. They're a very competitive team from the Nick 10. The Rockford Area Conference, and we look for a good game from them tonight. For the Knights, their record is 20-8, 10-3 in conference. They're led by Ryan David, Mark Lilly, Jake Gomes, Dylan Baca, and they've come on very strong since the Plano Christmas Tournament. I believe they've only lost two games since the Christmas Tournament, maybe three, but they've won 20 games. Back then, they had six wins. So we'll be back with the opening lineups right after this on TV 17 Sports.
20 years. Pegs on Main Street in Maple Park has provided quality professional hair care for the entire family. Peg and her staff keep up on the latest fashion trends for adults and children. She also carries a wide variety of hair care products for your convenience. And when they're finished pampering your hair, you can walk over and browse around the fantastic on-site gift shop. Stop in anytime at Pegs on Main in downtown Maple Park or give them a call at 815-827-3051.
Welcome back to TV 17 Sports. We're up here in Woodstock. Our first starter for the Knights is number 4, Ryan David. Our next starter is number 10, Ethan Conroy. We also have number 11, Mark Lilly, another starting guard for the Knights. Number 20, Dylan Baca. And our final starter will be senior Jake Gomes. The Knights are 20-8. We have them listed as 10-3 in conference. Now let's check out Rockford Boylan. These are the Titans. Number 10, Zach Cooper, first starter for the Titans. Number 12, did they say? Luke McDermott. Number 21, Hunter Deckman. Number 23, Anthony Foreman, another starter for the Titans. And finally, number 33, Sam Fairley, a 6'7 senior. So a little bit of a height advantage for the Titans. And we'll be back with our opening tip right after this. You're watching TV 17 Sports.
Like pizza, TV 17 Coupons has some great deals. How about $20 worth of menu items from Pisano's Pizza in Elburn for $10? Or a large cheese pizza with three toppings, a $20 value for $10 from Genoa's Pizza in Sugar Grove. Save money. Use TV 17 Coupons.
Your independent Allstate agent in Sugar Grove is David Weiss. With his friendly, courteous staff, David can give you the best rates for your home insurance as well as your auto insurance. Let him show you how to save money for all of your insurance needs. His office is conveniently located on Route 47 and Cross Street in Sugar Grove. call him anytime. His phone number is area code 630-466-7835.
And we're all set to go here in Woodstock. Woodstock North. Opening tip is grabbed by the Titans of Rockford Boylan. Crowd really excited here tonight. Pretty loud. Rockford moving the ball around. As the big man puts it up and in. That's Sam Fairley. So he gets the first points of the game. Full court pressure by Rockford Boylan. Knights break it easily. Lilly going to take it all the way. Drives, puts it up, off. Rebound grab, taken back and goes out of bounds. Last touch by number 12, Luke McDermott. So the Knights will get the ball back. Dylan Vaca will inbound the ball. Lilly bringing it down. Picked up by McDermott. Over to Conroy. Calling out a play. There's a three-pointer. A little bit too strong by David. Rockford Boylan grabs the rebound. Heckman with it. Number 10, Cooper now. Ball slapped out of bounds. And the Titans will keep the ball. Just underway, 7:04 left to go in the first period of play. 2-0's our score in favor of Rockford Boylan. Almost stripped away by Lilly. Playing some good D there. Pass in to the big man, loses control, steps on the line. Turnover, ball goes over to the Knights. Again, Knights played some good defense right there, forcing that turnover. David will inbound the ball, discarded by number 23, Foreman. David, over to Conroy. Pressure D there by Rockford Boylan. Gets it into Gomes. And the Knights will set up a play. Woodstock North High School, that's where we're at. One of two high schools in Woodstock. Actually three, including Marion Central and the traditional Woodstock High School. Into Gomes, looking for somebody to pass to. Still looking. Almost had a 5-second call there. Ryan David. Tough D by the Titans. Lilly looking. Kind of dribbling, was eight through. He's bumped, no foul. Dylan Baca with a three-point attempt. Rebound grabbed there by Gomes. Conroy will tie at three, and he can't hit. Rebound comes out long and taken back by Cooper. Cooper over to the big man underneath, and a nice layup. And Foreman gets the putback. Conroy, Knights 0 for 4 from the floor, so they got to get that shooting touch in a hurry. Lilly back out to Conroy. 4-0's our score. Scoreboard's in my way, Gary. I can't even see the main scoreboard. Lilly picked up. Oh, his pass is intercepted. An off-balance pass, and we're going to have a foul here by Conroy as he bumped into number 10, Zach Cooper. Cooper is a 6'5" forward. That foul was on Conroy, his first foul, first team foul. Woodstock moving the ball around. I'm sorry, Rockford, and they just threw the ball away. Pass intended over on that far corner in front of the scorer's desk. Kaneland has yet to score. 5 minutes and 10 seconds to go here in the first period of play. 4-0 is our score. Mark Lilly over to Conroy. Dylan Vaca with it now. Spin move, stolen, taken back by Rockford. McDermott going to pass down court, but knocked out of bounds. But say last touched by, I believe, Zach Cooper. So the Knights get the ball back. David did deflect the ball, and then Cooper knocked it out of bounds. Conroy with it now. He's going to take it all the way, pass in to Vaca. Underneath to Gomes, and he's fouled, so he's going to get a couple free throws.
Number
4-0 is our score. And Gary kept talking about that height advantage that Rockford's got. First free throw's up and good. So the Knights are on the board as Gomes gets a free throw. 4-1 is our score. Second free throw, and that one around and in. So the Knights cut that lead in half. It's 4-2. Rockford Boylan crossing the timeline. That's McDermott with the ball. Over to the big man, Farrelly. And that shot taken. No, oh, nice rebound. Angelo Foreman got that rebound, went up for the shot, but he was fouled. So Dylan Baca picks up that foul. First free throw is up and in. Foreman with 3 points now. Mitch Green in for Kaneland. Number three, Angelo Seminario in for the Titans. 5-2 is our score. Second free throw is up and in. So 6-2 is our score now. Foreman made both free throws. He's got 4 points. Almost picked off, but Conroy manages to save it. It's going to drive all the way. Nice pass, but it's knocked out of bounds there by number 22. Who do we got there? Reed Roulette. Got his hands on it. That pass was into Gomes. Out to Conroy. Vaca will try a three and throws an air ball up. And out of bounds, it goes over to Rockford Boylan. Knights a little tight right now. Gary says they get a basket that'll loosen everything up. Travel call there. Referee said that Angelo Seminario kind of shuffled his feet. So Ryan David will inbound the ball, looking towards Mitch Green. Conroy with it, picked up by Seminario. Boylan playing some tough defense. Baca with it. Conroy will take the three. This time he hits. So Ethan missed his first three, but made the second one. And we have another foul here. Looks like Conroy, who just picked up another foul. I'm getting a little dressing down there by the coach. Didn't like him picking up his second foul right away. Seminario will inbound the ball. There is a shot from three-point land. No good. That was by the big man, Farrelly. Rebound taken by the Knights. Coming down court. Lilly has it. Thought about it. Gomes has it now. Back out to Dylan Baca. And they're giving Baca a hard time because of his air ball. The Rockford fans, it is. Do you know that you cannot say air ball up in Wisconsin now? They say that's poor sportsmanship. And there's a three-pointer by David. So the Knights up 8-6 now. Nice comeback. Six straight points on 2 3-point baskets. Drive to the hoop. No good, but the big man gets the rebound. He can't get to the fault. The other big man gets it up and in. It's Zach Cooper. He gets a basket. We have a tie score. 8-8 is our score with just under 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Knights were down quickly 6-2, but they came back solidly with 2 3-point baskets. Gomes. Back to David, thought about it. Out to Baca. Lilly will try the three, and he hits! A three consecutive three-pointers for the Knights. And they're up 11-8. Rockford coming back. Big man gonna drive all the way, lays it up and in. Fairley's got four now, and it's 11-10 in favor of Kaneland. Lilly loses control, picks it back up again. We'll try the shot. That one was off the front end of the iron. Rebound comes off long, and we have a foul on one of the Kaneland players. Looks like, was that Gomes? Yeah, Gary was right. He called it on Gomes. So that'll be Jake's first foul. Fourth team foul for the Knights. Boylan bringing the ball down. Fairley passed it back. Now we got Rolette with it. Rolette going to drive. Dish it off to the big man, Fairley, and he scores. He's got six, and Boylan back up 12-11. Boylan came into the game 29-2. Knights 20-8. Baca will try a three, and his shot falls loose, but it's grabbed by David. And a foul. Looks like somebody pushed off on David. I didn't catch the number. Well, so Fairley picks up that foul. His first foul. 22 going out of the game. That's Rolette. Who's back in there, Gary? I didn't see. Looks like 35. Kevin Diemer in now for Boylan. Vaca to inbound the ball. David over to Vaca. Gomes fell, picks himself up. Lilly calling out a play. Calls for Vaca to get the ball. Vaca almost threw it away, but Ryan David over there to scoop up that loose ball. Lilly looking. Knights taking their time. David with it now. He's going to put one up. Rebound grabbed by Gomes, and he's fouled. So Gomes will get a couple free throws. No, wait, the referee signaled it was foul was on the floor, so no fouls. So Hunter Deckman gets that foul. Third team foul, fourth team foul, actually. Gomes coming out of the game now for the Knights. Lilly has it. Back into the game was, let's see, Conroy. Vaca. Over to Conroy. Thought about it. Moves it back out. Under a minute to go. Vaca has it. Gonna drive it all the way. Puts it up. Can't get it to fall. Rebound grabbed there by the Titans. Ooh, big man underneath. And he puts it up and in. It scores. It's number 35. Diemer with that basket. And he was fouled. And we'll get a free throw. The score is 14-11 now on that basket. So Ryan David picks up that foul. Rockford on an 8-3 run right now. And Diemer puts the free throw up and in. So it's 15-11. Nice run here by the Titans. Knights, 30 seconds to go. Conroy with it. Over to Lilly. David wide open for the three. Bounce around. No good. And number 23, Foreman, grabbed that rebound. Rocker looks like they will hold for the last shot. And that's Rolette with it. Oh, and we have a player control foul, a charge, as Conroy got knocked down. So the Knights will get a chance for the last shot in the period. So Rolette picks up his second foul. 15 foul for the Titans of Rockford Boylan. Lilly down to 9 seconds. 5 seconds left. Vaca better hurry, puts it up. Rebound. Green knocked to the floor. They say no foul. So our first period will end with the score, Rockford Boylan 15, the Kaneland Knights 11. Back with more action right after this. You're watching TV 17 Sports.
Looking for endless potential in one machine? The Kubota BX series is America's best-selling subcompact tractor. It's the one machine that can take on nearly any outdoor project. Now with Kubota's Orange Plus program, get customer instant rebates up to $1,300 when you buy a new BX70 and two implements. Take advantage of Orange Plus during our Power to Do Great Things sales event. Now with financing as low as 0% APR for up to 5 years.
Attention campers, attention campers. If you're looking for a new or pre-owner travel trailer, camping trailer, fifth wheel, toy hauler, accessible trailer, or destination trailer, go to Vacation Land in Big Rock, Illinois. You pay no fees. You're buying an RV, not fees. No freight, no setup, no propane charges, no hookup fees. Just your beautiful new RV ready for family fun. This message was brought to you by Vacation Land RV. We sell RVs, not bees. Call us at 630-556-3211 or go to our website, vacationlandrv.com, for more information.
Welcome back to Woodstock North High School. Sectional basketball here. Glenbard South beat Belvedere yesterday, so they're in the final. They'll be playing on Friday night against one of these two teams, Kaneland or Rockford Boylan. Kaneland with the ball now. David looking. Mitch Green almost lost it. Good defense so far by Rockford Boylan. Frustrating the Knights a little bit. Lilly picked up by McDermott. Vaca going to drive all the way, and he was fouled. And he's going to get two free throws. Rockford had been on a 9-3 run. Knights trying to end that right here. Rockford fans really giving Dylan Vaca a hard time. That silences them as he makes his free throw. And Gary says that's the best silencer you can, just knocking that free throw. Second one falls through, gets a friendly bounce. Dylan Vaca with 2 points, and our score is 15-13. Okay, the big man fairly going out. And I think we've got 35 in. Deemer. So Boylan brings the ball across. That's Luke McDermott. Moving the ball around. Heckman with it, back over to Deemer. Nice pass underneath, and nice roll up there, 21. Deckman gets that basket. So he's got one, he's got his first basket. Rebound there, grab. And that rebound was grabbed by 35, again, Deemer. Ball goes out of bounds. 6:52 left to go here in the first half, 17-13 is our score. Knights with the ball. Conroy coming in, Lilly going out. Into Conroy. Over to Vaca. Needs some help. David with it, back to Vaca. Into Conroy, nice pass in there. Green thought about it. Kicks it back out. Ryan David with it, rather Conroy with it now. Gomes back in the game. Ooh, taken back there and a little poke in the eye to Zach Cooper. He grabbed that loose ball and Rockford fans are very upset. They want a foul, but they're not going to get it. I take it back. They do get the foul. Gomes picks it up. As going for that loose ball, he poked Cooper in the eye. So that turnover, Rockford has a chance to pad their lead. Boylan in that Nick 10 conference, along with Rockford Auburn, which is usually a very good team. And they were this year. Nice pass. Outside shot. And Cooper can't get it to fall. And the rebound taken by Lilly. Lilly setting things up. Looking for Vaca. Ryan David will take the shot. That's a little bit too strong. Rebound almost grabbed and almost saved by Lilly, but he just couldn't get over there in time. His quick hands almost resulted in getting that ball back. Boylan will inbound the ball. Diemer with it. Into McDermott. He's picked up by Lilly. Seminario, he has it. McDermott thought about it. Moving the ball around. Seminario going to drive in, and the ball knocked away, then knocked out of bounds by Diemer. So the Knights will get it. Philly picked up by Seminario. Full court pressure there by Boylan. Lilly breaks it though. You got Mason Conroy, number 12, in there now. Vaca will stop, he'll shoot. And he missed again. Rebound picked up by Cooper. He's going to take it all the way and knocked out of bounds. Good play there by David, forcing the turnover. Last touch there by Cooper. So we've been stuck on 17-13 for the past minute and a half or so. Pressure defense continues by Boylan. Nice pass underneath. Green can't hold on, but he gets the handle on it, puts it up and in. So Mitch Green with his first basket, and it's 17-15. Diemer, McDermott, Seminario going to drive it all the way. Nice pass underneath the Diemer. And he hits that bunny. And it's 19-15. David, over to Lilly. Oh, stolen by Seminario, snuck in from behind. David went to block it, but he fouls him, and the ball falls through. And Seminario gets his first basket, and he'll get a free throw. 21-15 is our score. So we're in the bonus now, too. So Boylan will be stepping up to the free throw line after every foul after this. Seminario will try to complete the three-point play, and he does. So Angelo's got 3 points now, and it's a 22-15 score, and that's the biggest lead of the game for Boylan. And a real quick 5-point run. Mitch Green with it. Over to Mason Conroy. Going to pass back into Green. Tried to pass it and it's knocked away. And that's an obvious charge. As Hunter Deckman ran over Conroy. The infamous player control foul, as Gary likes to call it. So 16 fouls now, and we have a timeout. Rockford Boylan calls a timeout, so we'll take a timeout too. 4:05 left to go in the first half. 22-15 our score in favor of Boylan. Back after this on TV 17.
Hi, I'm Connie with JR Shooting Sports. With turkey season upon us, we have everything you need for when you go into the field. As any hunter can tell you, bagging the elusive gobbler is always a challenge. Here at JR Shooting Sports, we have the guns, the ammunition, the optics, and the clothes you need for your quest for the spring turkey. So stop on in at JR Shooting Sports. We're located on Oakhurst Drive in Aurora. and check us out on Facebook.
For more than 30 years, locally owned Kierhofer Sports has been the primary supplier of sports equipment for schools, teams, clubs, and organizations throughout Northern Illinois. Both team and retail customers can browse around Kierhofer Sports' 5,000 square foot store on Aurora's west side to choose among dozens of selections of popular team and sporting apparel. There's always a wide selection of pro sports jerseys and hats, high school sweatshirts, shoes for any athletic event, and just about any sporting equipment you need, including a new rewards program. Kierhofer Sports has the items you need for gifts, the big game, or to root for your favorite team. For more information, check us out on Facebook.
And we're back at Woodstock North High School, where the Knights trail 22-15 to the Titans of Rockford Boylan. Long pass down to Conroy, almost lost control, double team, in trouble, better call. No, he knocks it off of a good play there. He bounced it off of Luke McDermott out of bounds. For a moment there, I thought he was going to have to call a timeout to save it from being turned over. David back into Conroy. And that's Ethan Conroy. Pressure defense again by Boylan. Lilly out to Vaca. Conroy, oh, had a wide open attempt. Opportunity, I should say. Thought about it again. Brings it back out. 3:40 to go. Stops. Moves around. Lilly calls out a play. Passes it in to David. He's going to move it back out mid-screen. Over to Vaca, going to drive all the way in. And he gets a basket, and he's fouled. Dylan Vaca went strong dribble drive. Gets his basket. That's his first basket. But he's got 4 points now, and he'll get an opportunity for the three-point play. 22-17 is our score. Okay, here's our first free throw, our opportunity now for the three-point play. It is up and good. So Vaca now with 5 points, and it's a four-point ball game, 22-18. Knights a little light pressure on now. Conroy backs off now. Rolette with the ball. He's got two fouls. He's in a Knight sandwich there, but he gets rid of the ball. McDermott to the corner. And that's a three by number 23, Foreman. Foreman with 7 points now. Vaca picks up that loose ball, and he loses control. Referee says last touch by Vaca. Back up to a seven-point lead for Boylan, and they've got the ball. 2:58 left to go here in the first half. Rolette across the timeline, picked up by Conroy. There's a nice drive to the hoop, and Cooper scores. And it's a 9-point lead for Boylan, and Taylor will take a timeout, so we will too with 2:39 left to go in the first half. 27-18 is our score. Back after this.
Weekend is just an excuse to get a long way from boring. With models up to 62 horsepower or room for four. Go rugged. Go big. Go Gator.
Hi, I'm Dave Gieske from Buck Brothers in Hampshire. We have three other locations to serve you: Harvard, Wakanda, and Libertyville.
We're back at Woodstock North High School where the Knights are behind 27-18, a 9-point deficit. Just a few minutes ago, they were down by four. Lilly has it. A full court pressure by Boylan. Oh, man, open underneath, and it's knocked away. Momentarily, Mitch Green was opened by Luke McDermott, stepped in and deflected that pass. went out of bounds, and the Knights will get the ball. As Gary said, they really need a basket right here. There's a drive by Vaca, rejected there. It was Cooper that blocked that. He takes it down. Rollette back out. Cooper put it up and in, and he scores. It is now an 11-point lead, 29-18. Knights loose, throw the ball away, wide open, and another easy basket for Foreman. Knights may need a timeout. 31-18, and it's stolen again. Bad pass, that's up and in. They got to get a timeout. And that was McDermott with his first basket. And it's a 15-point lead now for Rockford Boylan. Knights looked at a little bit unsettled. Three consecutive turnovers there. Conroy with it. Dylan Vaca into Ryan David. He's going to try driving it. Loses control but gets it back. Throws it up and in. Kind of a hook shot there and it fell. So David with five, and that stops the bleeding there. 33-20. Cooper with it. Over to Foreman, back to Cooper. Out to Rollette. Boylan will take their time. Deemer with it now, gonna try to drive all the way in. Lilly grabbed that loose ball. Knights running, 3-on-2. Conroy up around, no good. Conroy, I should say, tried that three-pointer, had a good look at it, but it doesn't fall. Knights trail by 13. Boylan looks like they'll hold for the last shot. 33 seconds left to go here in the half. There's a bump by Conroy, but no penalty, no foul. Lilly picks up McDermott. Down to 20 seconds, McDermott will drive. Double team, they kick it back out. Rollette will set things up again, down to 12 seconds. Conroy on him, he's gonna take it all the way up and in. Rollette with his first basket. Lilly will stop and shoot, and can't get it to fall. And that's the end of our first half. Rockford Boylan with a 15-point lead. Our score, Boylan 35, Kaneland 20. We'll be back to check out our scores and some other highlights, our point totals, right after this. You're watching TV 17 Sports.
Hodges Westside Truck Center is the place to go if you need a work truck for your business. Hodges offers a wide variety of trucks to meet your needs. And we have two locations to serve you, in Marengo and in Elburn. And that's where you can browse around and find the right truck for you. We also service what we sell. We have an excellent parts and customer service department, and we also have a complete workshop to make the repairs you need to keep your truck on the road. Our Elburn facility is located on Main Street just east of Route 47, and in Marengo, you can find Westside Truck Center on Route 20 Grant Highway near I-90.
Welcome back to Woodstock North High School, our sectional battle this Wednesday evening, and the Knights have everything they can handle with Rockford Boylan. We thought it might be a little bit closer than this, but Gary said early on that Rockford's got some height advantage, and it turned out they're quicker than we thought, too. It was close there for a while. Dylan Vaca scored a basket and made the score 22-18, and then Boylan finished with a 13-2 run, and that makes our score at halftime 35-20. Checking our scoring for the Knights, they're led by two players, Dylan Vaca with 5 points, three throws and a basket. And let's see, Ryan David, he also has 5 points with a three-point basket and a two-point basket. We have Ethan Conroy with a three-point basket, Mark Lilly with a three-point basket, and Mitch Green with a basket. Jake Gomes has two free throws for the Knights, 20 points. For Boylan, they're led by Anthony Foreman. He's got 9 points. They got six from Zach Cooper. Also got six from the big man, Sam Fairley. 3 points from Angelo Seminario, two from Hunter Deckman, two from Reed Rollette, and also 2 points from Luke McDermott for their 35 points, again on a 13-2 run at the end of the half to put them comfortably in front. We'll be back with second half action right after this. You're watching TV 17 Sports.
Hi, I'm Melissa Garcia of RE/MAX All Pro in Sugar Grove. If you're thinking of buying or selling a home this season, we can help. Our team approach helps provide personal and professional assistance in your home buying needs. If you're looking for a home, our buyer specialist team can assist you with every facet necessary for a successful buying experience. If you're considering putting your house on the market, we showcase your home both in print with local periodicals, newspapers, and the real estate book, and online at enhancedsiteswithrealtor.com, Zillow, homes.com, and Trulia, not to mention many more, and also on the go by assigning QR codes, text codes, and mobile sites that connect your home to mobile consumers on the go. Let the Melissa Garcia team at RE/MAX All Pro help you find the perfect home or help you get the highest and best price for your current home. Call or text anytime at 630-878-9868 or visit our website at www.melissagarciahomes.com.
We're back at Woodstock North. Knights trail by 15. They need to make things happen right now. Boylan in command. Quick team. McDermott with it. Long pass down. Cooper with it. Now he's going to take it to the hoop. Drives it in. Ball goes off to, who was that? Number 21. Deckman gets that basket. So up to a 17-point lead. David. Again, stolen again. That's, oh, but he gets it back. Nice play by Ryan David, and he passes it down to Dylan Vaca. Vaca tried to pass it in to David, but the ball was knocked out of bounds, but I think there was a foul there, too. I don't know, 33? No, McDermott. He picks up his second foul. So the Knights trailing by 17 need to get something going right now. Conroy looking to pass it in. Into Gomes, back to Conroy. Brings it back out. Knights set up their defense. Lilly has it. Into Ryan David. Conroy will try the three and a little bit too strong. Knights try to get the rebound, but David couldn't get over there in time, goes out of bounds. And Boylan will take over, and it'll be Sam Fairley to inbound the ball. Knights with a little pressure now. Fairley gets it back. He'll bring it down himself. There's a stop and a pop. No good, but nice rebound there by Foreman. Deckman back in the game now, doing a lot for Rockford. There he is right there, getting some rebounding and some putbacks. Picks up the ball there, wide open for Fairley, but he misses it. Gets the ball back, though, going to drive in. Underneath for Cooper, and he puts it up and in. Rockford just dominating the boards there. Willie all the way, and he's fouled. Going up, then. He will get a couple free throws. 39-20 is our score. Boylan with the first 4 points of the second half. Like we said, Gary, it was a close game until the last 3 minutes, 3.5 minutes of the first half. Rockford went on that huge run. Mark Lilly gets that free throw. He has 4 points now. 18-point ball game now, 39-21. It's not over yet. Knights need to put together a run themselves. Second one. Battle for the rebound taken by Boylan. McDermott gets it, double teamed. Almost stolen, but they get it back. Nice pass to Diemer, blocked by Gomes. Conroy passes to Vaca, up and in. He's got 7 points now. Knights have 4 points now. Wide open there. Shot was no good. Rebound grabbed by the Knights. Knights running now. Conroy has it now. Back over to Vaca. Boy, a little sloppy the last two times down. Knights chipping away at that lead. David will shoot up, around, and over the backboard, so the ball will go back over to the Titans of Boylan High School in Rockford. 39-23 is our score. Knights almost have to score every trip down court now. Lily bothering McDermott. Thought about the three there. Cooper with it now. He'll stop and shoot around. Nice rebound underneath, and then a dish off back to Cooper. And Cooper's got 10 points. Back up to an 18-point lead, 41-23. David with it. Conroy, double team, back over to David. And Lily has it. He looks. Lily gonna try to drive, gonna bring it back out. Conroy. Into David. David has his pocket picked by McDermott. Three on one break. And Lily is going to pick up a foul as he fouled McDermott going to the hoop. So he'll get a couple free throws.
David fouls at number 11. Lily is first personal. First team foul.
So as you probably heard the public address announcer, that's his Lily's first foul, first team foul for Kaneland. And that's the first team foul in this second half, that is. McDermott going to put his free throw up and in. He's got 3 points now. 42-23, 19. This ties them for their biggest lead of the night, Gary. 2nd free throw coming up. And that one is good. So Boylan with a 20-point lead now, 43-23. David will inbound the ball. Over to Lily, double team. David gets it back. They try to break that press. They do. Boylan quickly back down court. That's the one thing they've done. They put on that full court press and they get back real quickly to play defense. It was Deemer grabbing that rebound. Cooper will try a three and doesn't get it to fall, but a nice rebound, but it's stripped away, taken back there. Quick hands by Boylan. Underneath now, blocked by David. Nice block. Down court. Vaca tries a backhanded shot, kind of a behind the back. He was too far underneath the basket. A block there by David. Really playing some good defense there by David. Vaca now, let's see, did he get all ball or is that a foul? Rockford fans thought that he got all ball, but referees say he did catch his hand. So Deckman with his third personal foul and Vaca will get a couple free throws. First free throw is up and in. Vaca has 8 points. Back down to a 19-point lead. Second free throw coming up. And that one too strong off the iron, but the Knights get the rebound. Vaca gets it back. Gonna bring it back out. Conroy has it. Knights need to score just about every trip down. Vaca will take it all the way in and puts it up. Can't get it to fall. Green tried to grab the rebound. Rocker gets the ball back. Down court. He traveled. That was, who's that, Gary Deckman? Wanted to pass it to his man breaking underneath, but he shuffled his feet. Couldn't complete the play. So with that turnover, the Knights get the ball back. They trail by 19. Conroy going out. Who we have coming in there? We have his brother. Ethan goes out. Mason comes in. Number 12, Mason Conroy. Lily, nice spin move. Double teamed, in trouble, but gets rid of it. Pass into Vaca, over to Lily. He's in trouble in the corner again, but gets it out to David. Underneath, and Gomes gets a nice basket underneath. Nice pass, and it's 43-26. Conroy, a little pressure. Seminario in there now. He's going to take it all away, dishes off, and Deemer will shoot, miss, and Green with the rebound. Over to Lily. Knights trying to cut into that lead. Lily stops. Over to Green. Oh, off his foot. Green tried to drive and lost control of the ball, went out of bounds, and the Titans get the ball back. The Knights had a golden opportunity to cut the lead to 15 there. Boylan ahead by 17. 2:25 left to go in the third period. The ball knocked away, last touched by number 24. Who was that, Gary? I have to check my scorecard here. 24 is Rhett Espy. No, I'm sorry. I don't have him. Conroy, oh, he throws it away. Deemer picks it up for the Titans. McDermott, Cooper has it. McDermott thought about it, and there's our number 24. He can't score. Rebound grab back, and a little undercut there by Conroy. Let's see, I'm looking for number 24, Max Farson, that's who it is. So we got a timeout with our score 43-26. The Knights take a timeout, so we will take a break too. Back after this on TV 17 Sports.
20 years, Pegs on Main Street in Maple Park has provided quality professional hair care for the entire family. Peg and her staff keep up on the latest fashion trends for adults and children. She also carries a wide variety of hair care products for your convenience. And when they're finished pampering your hair, you can walk over and browse around the fantastic on-site gift shop. Stop in anytime at Pegs on Main in downtown Maple Park or give them a call at 815-827-3051.
1 minute, 49 seconds left to go here in the third period of play. Knights trail. Boylan, scenario, he'll shoot. Rebound grabbed away there by Cooper as the battle went between David and Cooper. I think they call a held ball, so who will get the ball? Oh, no, they will call a foul on David. So three team fouls for both teams now. Cooper with it, bumped out of bounds, or a bump away from the ball, actually. Nice spin move. Gomes tried to save the ball, but he stepped out of bounds. Gary, we've got the Rockford TV stations here tonight. They're going to be on there. When you get home tonight, you want to put on the Rockford stations and watch the news. You might see yourself in there. Boylan will inbound the ball now. And here's a drive. Nice pass underneath, and we're going to get a what? Is that a blocking foul or a charge? It's going to be a charge. Player control foul. Rockford fans upset. I really don't know why they're up by 17 points. Conroy, full court pressure again. We've got 15 in there for the Knights now. Mitch Green with it. David. Baca will drive all the way, takes it, and it's blocked. Ball taken back by Boylan. Nice interception there. And who was that, number 15? Jake Held. Nice interception. He's in the game now. Long three-pointer. Nice rebound, though, by David. Nice putback. Ryan David right on the where he had to be. And it's 43-28 back up to, back down, I should say, to a 15-point lead. Boylan, looks like they'll hold on. 40 seconds left. See if they will hold on for the last shot. Seminario back over to Cooper. Cooper guarded by David. Seminario loses control of the ball. Oh, no foul. We have a battle for it. Now we get the held ball. And an injured player there for the Knights. Looks like David getting up very slowly. Possession arrow to who, Gary? I didn't catch that. Over to the Knights. No. Boylan, I think, will get it. I'm wrong. The Knights get it. 22 seconds left to go. Kaneland will get the ball on that held ball. Mitch Green will inbound it to Lilly. 20 seconds left. See if they can hold on for that last shot. It was a disaster at the end of the second quarter trying to do this as they turned the ball over twice. Green looking, needs some help. Held comes over to give him a hand. Lilly has 6 seconds. Lilly will drive all the way and rebound, no! Knights had a chance, but boy, that Rockford defense just too much for him. So at the end of three periods of play, our score, Rockford Boylan 43, the Kaneland Knights 28. Back with our final period of play right after this on TV 17 Sports.
Looking for a new utility vehicle experience? Now, during our Power to Do Great Things sales event, get a Kubota RTV-X, the best-selling diesel utility vehicle in the industry. They've earned their place by being durable and reliable under all kinds of conditions. Now, get a new RTV-X series utility vehicle for zero down and 0% financing for 4 years. And for a limited time, get $400 to $1,000 in customer instant rebates.
Hodges Westside Truck Center is the place to go if you need a work truck for your business. Hodges offers a wide variety of trucks to meet your needs. And we have two locations to serve you, in Marengo and in Elburn. And that's where you can browse around and find the right truck for you. We also service what we sell. We have an excellent parts and customer service department, and we also have a complete workshop to make the repairs you need to keep your truck on the road. Our Elburn facility is located on Main Street just east of Route 47, and in Marengo, you can find Westside Truck Center on Route 20 Grant Highway near I-90.
8 minutes to go in the Kaneland Knights season. They need a big comeback here if they're going to continue playing on Friday. Boylan with a 15-point lead, and they've got the ball. Cooper back out to Rolette. Back to McDermott. McDermott, Foreman has it, back over to Fairley. Fairley will try to muscle his way in, and he does. Back up to a 17-point lead. Lilly, three-point attempt, and it's good by Held. 45-31, oh, Rockford answers. And Fairley, and they steal the ball back, but luckily Lilly's there to pick up the loose ball for the Knights, and he's fouled. Knights had a 3-1 break, 3-on-1 break, so that was a good foul by Rockford there. Had it down to 14 points, but Boylan comes right back with that three-pointer. .6:53 left to go in the ball game. Dylan Vaca will inbound the ball. Vaca will try the three. Was he fouled? If he was, he's going to get three free throws. Now they'll say he was fouled on the floor. Deckman now four fouls, so he's got to get out. Now they're leaving him in for right now. Conroy. Thought about it. David will shoot. He hits. So Ryan David with a three-pointer, and the Knights will call a quick timeout. Our score is 48 to 34. 6:41 left to go. We'll be back right after this on TV 17 Sports.
Hi, I'm Connie with JR Shooting Sports. With turkey season upon us, we have everything you need for when you go into the field. As any hunter can tell you, bagging the elusive gobbler is always a challenge. Here at JR Shooting Sports, we have the guns, the ammunition, the optics, and the clothes you need for your quest for the spring turkey. So stop on in at JR Shooting Sports. We're located on Oakhurst Drive in Aurora. And check us out on Facebook.
48-34 is our score here at Woodstock North High School. We're in the sectionals. The winner plays for the championship on Friday. Full court press by the Knights, trying to get a turnover. Foreman, Seminario. Back out to Rolette. He's picked up by Conroy. Knights trying to turn up that D. And Boylan trying to run off some clock. Cooper fell. Fairly with it now. Cooper going to drive. He loses control. Knights pick up the ball. No foul. Conroy very upset. The Knights retain possession, but no foul called. So the Knights will get it. There's that pressure defense again. It has bothered the Knights all night long. Lilly. Vaca will try a three, and he hits. Well, Gary said if they hit a couple threes, they might get back in the ball game. It's an 11-point game now. Knights all of a sudden hot from the outside. Rolette over to Cooper. Oh, he's open, and he scores. Big man Fairley snuck in behind the defense, and he gets the basket, puts it back up to a 13-point lead. Another timeout, so we'll take one. 50 to 37 is our score. Back after this on TV 17.
For more than 30 years, locally owned Kierhofer Sports has been the primary supplier of sports equipment for schools, teams, clubs, and organizations throughout Northern Illinois. Both team and retail customers can browse around Kierhofer Sports' 5,000 square foot store on Aurora's west side to choose among dozens of selections of popular team and sporting apparel. There's always a wide selection of pro sports jerseys and hats, high school sweatshirts, shoes for any athletic event, and just about any sporting equipment you need, including a new rewards program. Kierhofer Sports has the items you need for gifts, the big game, or to root for your favorite team. For more information, check us out on Facebook.
5:39 left to go. Knights trying to make a comeback. They did get within 11 there just a moment ago. Lilly has it. He's picked up. Conroy back to Lilly. Thought about it. Looking for someone to pass to. Vaca thought about a long three-pointer. Conroy into David. David gonna drive it. He was hit. Bump. No foul. And David will kind of look, he gave him a knee almost. He's trying to block the pass. And Cooper goes down, but he's up, he's okay. Do they call a foul or not? Uh, He's got four fouls now. Number four with four. Just over 5 minutes left to go in the ball game. Boylan taking their time, gonna burn off some clock. Seminario wide open though for the three, can't get it to fall. Nice rebound though. And that was Cooper, he can't get it. And then battle for the ball underneath. That was Foreman, but he knocks it out of bounds and the Knights will get the turnover. And looks like there was a foul too. And they're in the bonus, okay. That's a 17 foul for Boylan. So, will that be Conroy with the free throws, Gary? Yes, it will be. Well, if you can make these free throws, it's great to score with no time being taken off the clock. First one, no good. They needed that. And okay, they got the rebound. Held, I'm sorry, Gomes got it. And he was bumped. And the foul was on the Rockford player that's down. Is that Seminario? So he picked up the foul. Looks like we may have an injury timeout here, Gary. So that means, I guess, we'll take a timeout real quickly, and we'll be back right after this on TV 17.
Four-wheel steering is why I get up in the morning.
The only thing better than the smell of fresh-cut grass is the smell of perfectly level, fresh-cut grass.
That yellow seat's my favorite chair.
You want to find a John Deere dealer? Just set your GPS to Tractor Experts.
When my grandson grows up, it's his, but it's all mine now.
That's how we run, and nothing runs like a Deere.
Stop by at Buck Brothers anytime, Route 20 and 47, Hampshire.
So that was Angelo Seminario being helped off the court as he hurt his, looks like his knee, Gary said. And the Knights will get a couple free throws. Once again, a chance to cut into that lead. Gomes' first free throw was good. Jake has 5 points, including three free throws. 50-38. If he makes this one, that'll be the closest the Knights have been. No, they couldn't make it. Just missed, bounce off to the side, and the rebound taken there by Boylan. McDermott picked up by Lilly. Again, they'll try to work some clock. The big man will pass down. McDermott gets it back. They got Deckman in there. I wonder if they're right. They said he had four fouls. I can't tell, but he's in the ball game. Nice drive to the hoop, and it's up and in by Cooper. Cooper with 12 points, back up to a 14-point lead. Lilly, Vaca, gonna stop and try a three, might as well. Up and around, and rebound grabbed there by Boylan. They'll slow it down, wait for their teammates to get down. McDermott, fairly thought about it. Almost threw it away. Nice pass underneath the Foreman, and he puts it up and in. And Foreman's got 9 points. Lilly almost loses the ball. They're calling a held ball. But a possession arrow says the Knights will keep the ball. Back up to a 16-point lead. 3:38 left to go in the ball game. Knights trying to make one last run. Conroy with it. He's going to drive all the way. Stops. Nowhere to go. Vaca will try it now. And he's going to get a charge. Was that Vaca or was that Green? Yeah, it was Vaca. Couldn't quite tell. Almost lost it. Get the ball back. Boylan is running clock now. McDermott picked up by Lilly. Lily's going to bump him. Boylan still has it. McDermott going to pass underneath, and that's the, oh, the big man will try a three. This time he doesn't make it. So Fairley missed from the outside, and Baca picked up that rebound. Spins. Lily was open, decides to drive in, and he lost control of the ball, taken back by Boylan. Under 3 minutes to go in the ball game, and the season for the Knights. Fairley over to Deckman. Deckman looking. Back over to Cooper. Picked up by Lily. Just gonna keep burning off some clock. Cooper guarded by Lily. He's gonna stop. Kicks it back out again. They'll start all over. Just over 2 minutes left to go. 14-point lead. And Boylan playing a good game of keep away. They get the foul now. 2 minutes and 1 second left to go. And the Knights have another foul to give before Boylan goes to the free throw line. So Deckman will inbound the ball. Deckman will ball almost stripped away, but it's a foul there by Lily as Deemer lost control of the ball, but he was fouled. So that will put them in the bonus. So gets a 1-1. So Deemer, 1-1. One in the bonus. Up and in. Deemer now has 7 points. And it's a 55-38 score. Second free throw, and that one's good. So 56-38. Under 2 minutes left to go in the season for the Knights. Lily driving all the way, draws the foul. So he'll get a couple free throws. 1:53 left to go in our ball game. First free throw by Lily is up and in. As Lily, that's his 5th point. He's got a 3-point basket and 2 free throws. Second attempt coming up now, and that one is off and bounds off the front end of the iron and taken back by Boylan. Their defense, what they're doing right now, Boylan, is kind of like a football team when they're taking a knee. McDermott bumped. That's going to have to foul him. And they steal it. Lily with a nice steal. Going to slow it down now. Now he's going to take it to the hoop. Up and in. Now, is it a player control foul? Yeah, they call it a charge. It was a nice move and a good acting job by the Rockford player, according to Gary. And I think he's right. That's a big guy that he knocked down. Oh, now with a song by Steam. Remember that? Na, na, hey, hey, kissing goodbye. One 19 left to go, double team there. Heckman with it, he's bumped by Gomes. Underneath to McDermott and an easy layup. McDermott with 5 and it's 58-39, under a minute to go. And we have a timeout. So with 54 seconds left to go in this ball game, 58-39 is our score. We'll take a timeout, too, back after this on TV 17 Sports.
If you like pizza, TV 17 Coupons has some great deals. How about $20 worth of menu items from Pisano's Pizza in Elburn for $10? Or a large cheese pizza with three toppings, a $20 value for $10 from Genoa's Pizza in Sugar Grove. Save money. Use TV 17 Coupons.
Number 15, Jake Held, back in the ballgame. We also have number 34, that's Dean Frank, as Kaneland putting some subs in. Also 32, and I'll have to catch his name in a minute. There's Mitch Green, double teamed. He's gonna finally force one up. Doesn't fall. And almost taken there by Jake Held. Underneath, and doesn't fall. Knights get the ball back. Mason Conroy with it. Over to Held. Held will try a three, and he misses everything, but Green gets the rebound. Green's going to try to drive it all the way in, and he's fouled. So we'll see if we can pick up number 32 there. That's Ben Ambrose.
Brother Casa 34, Zuba, brings the first personal team.
Here I go again. I'm looking at the wrong team. That's Josh Marchuk. I'm sorry, Josh. So second attempt there by Green, and he makes that one. 58-40, and that'll just about do it here. I don't think the Knights will put any pressure on them. They'll just let the clock run out. No, they will put a little pressure on, and they'll foul him. So that's number 32. As we check our scorebook, these are the guys that don't get in too much during the regular season. That's Ben Ambrose. Well, I had the right name before, just the wrong team. And he puts it up and in. Ben gets in the scoring column, and it's 59-40. Second free throw coming up now, and that one is no good. Rebound taken by the Knights and lost. Now they get it back. 8 seconds left to go. Conroy looking. Is he going to? And he throws it away. Oh. They were taking their turn. They try to get it to Marchuk, but ball went out of bounds. And that should do it. Our final score, Rockford Boylan 59, the Kaneland Knights 40. We'll be back with a recap right after this. You're watching TV 17 Sports.
Remember when you were a kid? You liked getting dirty and building things? There were no limits. You could move mountains. The John Deere 1 Series subcompact tractor. The way grown-ups move mountains. And with Auto Connect implements, it's the easiest tractor to use yet.
Hi, I'm Dave Gieske from Buck Brothers. See these products in our complete lineup of John Deere equipment at our location at Route 20 and 47, Hampshire.
Well, it had to end for the Knights. They had a nice run at the end of the season. They put together a nice little winning streak. But they lost tonight to a very good Rockford Boylan team. They were quicker than I thought they would be. The height and their quickness led to a lot of turnovers, and they just were the better team tonight. Checking our scoring, Ryan David led all scorers in the game, or he tied actually with Fairley, but he had 13 points for the Knights, including 3 3-point baskets. Knights also got 8 points from Dylan Vaca, 5 from Mark Lilly, 5 from Jake Gomes, 3 from Ethan Conroy, and we also got 3 points from Jake Held for the 40 points that the Knights scored. They had 20 in the first half, 20 in the second half. It was that 13-2 run at the end of the first half that's kind of sealed their fate. Knights finish up 21-8. either that or 21-8, 21-9. Nobody was quite sure what the record was when I was asking around, but still a great season. For the victorious Titans of Rockford, Boylan, they were led by Sam Fairley, their big center. He had 13 points. Zach Cooper, their guard, had 12. They also got 9 points from Anthony Foreman, very athletic player. Kevin Diemer had 8. They also got 4 from Hunter Deckman, 5 from Luke McDermott, and 3 points from Angelo Seminario, who was injured right near the end of the game. We hope he's okay. And a free throw right near the end by Ben Ambrose. And before we forget, we also had a basket by Reed Rollette, as he had 2 points for the 59-4 Rockford Boylan. They improved to 30-2. They will play Glenbard South for the sectional championship on Friday. Once again, our final score, 59-40 in favor of Rockford Boylan. For Gary Levitt, I'm Terry Wido. Thank you for watching. I think we'll see you in softball season coming up pretty soon. See you next time.
Energized for some more fishing. Yum.
Life is good. For surface fishing, we're using size 2 bass poppers in yellow and white. The leader has a 6-foot tapered butt and a 16-inch tippet of 3X fluorocarbon on a size 7 floating line. Subsurface, we're using Ken's own crayfish pattern. There's a 4-foot fast sinking tip tied to our floating line. Attached to that is a 3-foot 2X fluorocarbon tippet.